Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the major news developments from across the world. Our headlines. COVID-19 cases across the world crossed 786,000. US is twice the number of cases as China. Hungarian Prime Minister Viktor Orban assumes emergency powers citing pandemic. Palestinians mark land day and anniversary of the Great March of Return. And the ELN announces a ceasefire in Colombia. We begin with our daily COVID-19 segment. The number of cases as of 9 a.m. GMT was over 786,000. The number of deaths was close to 38,000. The US has now twice the number of cases as China, with the peak death toll estimated to be seen in a few weeks. Across the world, countries continue to tighten travel norms and move into various stages of lockdown. With over 164,000 cases, the outbreak in the United States has reached crisis-level proportions. It has added over 20,000 reported cases in a single day. In the meanwhile, six members of the US Congress tested positive yesterday, while 30 others are under self-imposed quarantine. Nevertheless, 230 members of the US House of Representatives attended a session to pass the CARES Act, which will infuse $2.2 trillion for measures to fight the infection. The attendance of Congress members, despite health risks, was necessitated after a Republican House member threatened to block the passing of the bill if half the members did not attend the session. The Congress is now speculated to go into a second phase of action to contain the COVID-19 epidemic in the country. At the same time, delivery and warehouse workers across the country went on strike yesterday over concerns about their health and safety. Strikes were organized at Instacart and Amazon in several facilities across the country, demanding protective gear and hazard pay for their work during the epidemic. Workers have also raised concerns of what they see as inadequate policies on part of the company, especially in ensuring a safe and hygienic work environment to prevent the spread of the disease among workers. In Europe, Spain continued to suffer with over 7,000 new cases and 913 new deaths recorded yesterday, even as the country is considering tougher restrictions. Italy recorded over 800 deaths yesterday, although the number of new cases has fallen. Italy too has extended the lockdown for at least 2 weeks. Meanwhile, in a dangerous development, Hungary's far-right-wing Prime Minister Viktor Orban has assumed virtually unlimited powers after a parliamentary vote on the government's request to rule by decree. The opposition severely criticized the move, saying that democracy itself had been placed in quarantine. Among the dangerous provisions are curbs on the media. Meanwhile, in the Asia-Pacific region, the WHO has warned that the pandemic is far from over. Countries in the region have seen an increase in cases, but no major spiraling as has happened in the West. The WHO official warned that countries where cases are declining or with slow growth rates must keep up with the vigil, else the pandemic might strike back again. China reported 48 new cases today, all of which were imports. In Africa, Tanzania became the latest country to report a death. In our In Focus section, we bring to you a feature on the issues faced by migrant workers in India after Prime Minister Narendra Modi declared a sudden lockdown last Tuesday. Thank you. Yesterday, March 30th, saw Palestinians marked the 44th anniversary of the Land Day as well as the second anniversary of the Great March of Return protests. However, due to the ongoing coronavirus pandemic, no mass rallies and organizations were organized, keeping in mind the health and safety of Palestinians. Instead, activists and Palestinian solidarity organizations announced that they would be holding an online rally and a Twitter storm to mark the anniversaries and to highlight the sufferings and struggles of Palestinians, especially in Gaza, who are living under a crushing Israeli-Egyptian land, air and sea blockade for the past 14 years. Palestinians in the occupied West Bank, occupied East Jerusalem and the Gaza Strip, as well as those in the diaspora in countries across the world, took to raising the flag on their rooftops and in their balconies. The Great March of Return began in 2018 to demand justice and the right of return for hundreds of thousands of Palestinians and their descendants who were forced to leave their homeland in what is called the Nakba during the formation of Israel. The Great March of Return became a symbol of Palestinian resistance and was met with horrific brutality by Israel. Close to 300 Palestinian protesters have been killed since the protests began. The Land Day marks the killing of six Palestinians in 1976 when they were resisting the confiscation of their land. In our next story, the left-wing Colombian national group, the National Liberation Army or the ELN, declared a unilateral ceasefire for the month of April in the face of the COVID-19 pandemic. In their ceasefire statement, they said that this is a humanitarian gesture from the ELN to the Colombian people who are suffering from the devastation of the coronavirus. The ELN explained that the cessation was active and that its combatants would defend themselves if they were attacked by Colombia's armed forces. The group called on the government of President Iván Duque to re-establish dialogue with their delegation in Havana, Cuba, to finalize a bilateral and temporary ceasefire. They also called for an end to the persecution of the people and the murder of social leaders and activists. That's all we have in this episode of the International Daily Roundup. To know more about these stories, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org and follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Thanks for watching.